Hello, welcome to a new episode. Today's topic is Principal Component Analysis Part 2, Dimensional Reduction. Today, we'll discuss about the dimensional reduction in the principal axis basis. We'll go through an example that can be easily visualized. A recap of the previous episode. The principal components can form a new basis where we can represent the data coordinates. There can be as many principal components as the number of dimensions or the number of variables. The principal components can be interpreted as new features or variables. The principal components are ordered from the largest variance to the smallest variance. We can keep only the first few principal components that account for most of the variation. This is in fact what we call the dimensional reduction. The benefits of the dimensional reduction are as following. We can extract the most noticeable and salient features from the data. As the basis set is reduced, it becomes simpler to represent the data. After the dimensional reduction, it will require less computer memory and processing power to treat the data. However, there are some negative aspects of the dimensional reduction. The principal components are linear combinations of the original variables, and they are usually harder to interpret. As we extract only the most noticeable features, we are losing some of the details, which may or may not be important themselves. As in the previous episode, let's imagine a two-dimensional dataset, which is easy to visualize. There can be as many principal components as the number of dimensions. So, in this case, we have two principal components. The first principal component is along the direction of the largest variance. The second principal component is orthogonal to the first one. It is along the direction of the remaining variance. The transformation to the basis of the principal components is like rotating the figure. The axes of the figure are now the principal components. Now we can reduce the dimension to 1. This means we are keeping only the projections onto the first principal axis and eliminating the second principal axis. Back to the original basis, the data coordinates are compressed along the direction of the largest variation. We can see that as a consequence of the dimensional reduction, there is some loss of details. This would be the downside of the dimensional reduction. As a result of the dimensional reduction, we get the commonality, which is the fraction of the variance of each variable that is accounted. The loading vectors are the coordinates of the normalized principal components. Then we have the representation of the input data using the reduced basis set. Examples. We have a data set of 23 variables and 23 rows or observations. And the data values seem to lie between 0 and 1. We go to the PrimaXL tab, select PCA, and then dimensional reduction. We select the cell range of the data set. The number of principal components has to lie between 1 and 23. For this example, we select 5. We check on this box to output the result to a new sheet. Here, we leave all these boxes as checked. Finally, we press the Run button to execute. Great! We are at the result sheet. We can see the commonality for each variable. In some cases, we have the value 1, and in some others, it is a number between 0 and 1. Next, we have the coordinates for the principal components shown as row vectors. These are the loading vectors. Here, we have the representation of the input data using the reduced basis set. So far, so good. But still, it is rather hard to visualize the effect of the dimensional reduction. So let's go back to the original data sheet and format the cells. Then let us apply the conditional formatting. We set the minimum to 0 and the maximum to 1. For the minimum, we pick the white color, and for the maximum, we pick the black color. Voila! The data seems to represent a grayscale image of number 9. Now, we go to the result sheet and then format the cells in a similar way. Well, here also we can see the number 9. However, this image is not as clear as the original. Let us increase one by one the number of principal components in the basis set, starting from 1 up to 10. We can see the improvement in the image quality as we increase the number of principal components in the basis set. When we include all of the principal components, we recover exactly the original image without any loss of details. In this plot, we show the cumulative variance as function of the number of principal components in the basis set. With 10 or more principal components, we can account for over 99% of the variance of the image data. Summary. Today we discussed about the dimensional reduction of the principal component basis. The key point is that we can represent the data with a much smaller basis set, where the loss of details is controlled by the number of the principal components. Please visit our Facebook page for more information and videos. Also, make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. You can find the PrimaXL installer at our GitHub repository. Thank you so much. Until next time, bye.